بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، ذكر الله تعالى. And what will make you know what is ذكر الله؟ ذكر الله, it means the remembrance of Allah عز وجل. ذكر الله, it means to remember Allah عز وجل with your tongue and your heart. It involves thinking of and making mention of Allah at all times and in every area of our lives. This is the worship that has no special time, but is performed constantly so that it permanently links your life with Allah and His service. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, when we listen to this ayah, straight away we come to know that it's a command from Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah says, فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. Then remember me, and I will remember you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا. All those who believe, اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ, remember Allah, ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا, and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot. It means to keep your tongue wet in the remembrance of Allah azza wa jal. Well, there are some people who believe that dhikr, it means just to keep on saying subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. No, dhikr is not only this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that the Quran is dhikr in itself, which means it makes you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What kind of dhikr are there? The first and foremost is the Quran. Reading and reciting the Quran is a form of remembering Allah azza wa jal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refers to the Quran as a dhikr, the remembrance or the reminder, in many places in the Quran. For example, in Surah Sad, the first verse, Allah says, صاد والقرآن ذي الذكر. But the Quran full of dhikr. And in another verse, Allah says, إنا نحن نزلنا الذكر وإنا له لحافظون. Indeed, we have sent the dhikr, the remembrance, and we shall protect it. Which is the Quran. Reading, understanding, reflecting, and pondering on Allah's words is the most effective way of remembering Him, subhanAllah. Dhikr also includes remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when one starts his day, at the point he gets up from his bed. Straight away, he remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us the remembrance to be said before we do many things in our life, during the day and the night. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran in Surah Ar-Rum, Allah says, فَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ حِينَ تُمْسُونَ وَحِينَ تُصْبِحُونَ وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَعَشِيًّا وَحِينَ تُظْهِرُونَ. فَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ. So glory be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the time you enter the evening and by the time you drive through the morning. وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And praise be to Him in the heaven and the earth. And the ayah continues. For example, the remembrance of morning and evening. Allah says, glory be to Him when the evening and the morning comes. And the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ taught us the dua, the adhkar, to be said in the morning and in the evening. Why? In order for us to be protected from shaitan and to get nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there are many dhikr to be said. For example, the morning remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal, what you said after Fajr and before, after Maghrib. The dua leaving and entering the house. The dua before and after eating. The dua or dhikr that you say after your fard salah. All these brothers and sisters, they are prescribed upon you to do so that you get nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even when we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala earnestly, this is also called dhikr. Dhikr can be done anywhere and at any time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, men who remember Allah standing, sitting and lying down on their sides and contemplate the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. Remember, we got to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do our adhkar the way the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us. We cannot just come here and do dhikr the way we want. We cannot do any kind of ibadah according to our own way. Or else, we will fall in what? Into innovation. We got to understand, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came on the face of the earth as our teacher, and he came to teach us, and he taught us the way of making dhikr of Allah azza wa jal. So if we want our adhkar and our remembrance of Allah azza wa jal to be accepted, there are two conditions that have to be there. This is the condition for all our ibadah. Number one, al-ikhlas, and number two, al-salah. Which means the first one is sincerity, and number two, it has to be done according to the way of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If ever we're doing our dhikr in a way that was not prescribed by the sunnah, it is going to be rejected. Even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah says, وَاذْكُرُوهُ كَمَا هَدَاكُمْ, and celebrate His praise. Remember Him the way He has directed you. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way He has directed you. So we shouldn't just come up here and then get into a group and then start chanting the name of Allah, start dancing, thinking we're going to get near to Allah Azza wa Jal. That was not the way the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did. If we want our dhikr or adhkar to be accepted, we have to do it the way the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has done it. What are the benefits of a dhikr? What do we get when we do dhikr? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran in Surah Al-Ra'd, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. Allah says, those who believe and they find their heart while they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at peace. For verily, in the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal, you find the tranquility of your heart. Subhanallah. The only way you want to find tranquility of your heart is by making dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal. And even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرَاتِ أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةً وَأَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. وَالذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرَاتِ. And among the men who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot, and among the women who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot, for them Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared forgiveness and great reward. Benefit of a dhikr, tranquility, forgiveness and great reward. And subhanallah, it is even said by the learned people, if you keep your tongue wet in the remembrance of Allah, the shahada of la ilaha illallah will be easy for you to say as your last word in the dunya before you pass away. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who remember Him day and night. Ameen.